Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will learn how to sort a stack. The question is, given a stack of integers, you ask it to sort it in place, so that the smallest value must be at the top of the stack, and you can use only one temporary stack and zero other data structures, which means that you can't use an array for example. Before starting, know that you can activate captions and that you will find the solution code in 4 programming languages in the first link in the description. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and to give me your feedback in comments. Now, let's start. And we have 4 main operations. We have push, to add an element to the stack. We have pop, to remove an element from the stack and return the popped value. We have peek, it returns the value of the element at the top without removing it, it just returns the value. And we have isEmpty, it just says if the stack is empty or not. Now before sorting a stack, let's sort a more familiar data structure, the array. Let's sort this array by using insertion sort algorithm. The insertion sort algorithm works this way. For each element in the array, we remove it, we keep shifting elements that are greater than him to the right, then we put it again before them. You'll better understand with this example. First we have 5, it has no precedent elements, so we put it again directly. Next element, 3. Because 5 is greater than him, we shift it to the right. And we put 3 again from the left. Next element, 2, we have 5, that is smaller than him, so we shift it. Same thing for 3, and we put 2 from the left. Now we have 8, 5 is not greater than him, so we directly put it again. Now we have 9, 8 is not greater, we put it again. Now we have 1, and 9 is greater, we shift. Same thing for 8, same thing for 5, same thing for 3, same thing for 2, and we put 1 from the left. Now, last element, 7, we have 9 that is greater, so we shift. And same thing for 8. And now 5 isn't greater, so we put 7 again. And as you can see, the array is now sorted. Now, let's try to apply this algorithm, but on a stack. The problem with the stack is that we can't directly iterate over the elements normally, because by definition, to access to an element in a stack, we must pop all the elements before it. And to avoid losing those elements, we have to use a temporary stack, where each time we pop an element from our stack, we push it in our temporary stack. So how can we apply insertion sort in a stack? For that, we pop the element at the top of the stack, then while it's smaller than the element at the top of temporary stack, we pop that element and we push it in our stack. After that, we push our popped element in temporary stack, and we repeat again until there are no elements left in stack. I know that it's not clear like this, but you will understand better with this example. We pop from stack, and we have the value 5. The temporary stack is empty, so we directly push our popped element into it. Now we pop the value 3 from the stack, and because the temporary stack peak is equal to 5, which is greater, we pop it from there and we push it into our stack. And we push our value 3 in the temporary stack. We repeat the process, we pop the value 5, and because it's not smaller than 3, we can directly push it. Now we pop the value 2, and because 5 is greater, we take it to stack, same thing for 3. Now we can push our 2, and we repeat. We pop the value 3, it's not smaller than 2, we directly push it. We pop the value 5, it's not smaller than 3, we directly push it. But wait, in the problem description, we said that the smallest value must be at the top of the stack at the end, and the opposite is happening here, the smallest value is at the bottom. Basically, we are storing values in descending order in temporary stack, because when we will put them in stack at the end, they will become in ascending order. You'll see it later. But before, let's continue our work. So now we pop the value 8, it's not smaller than 5, we directly push it. We pop the value 9, it's not smaller than 8, we directly push it. Now we pop the value 1, it's smaller than 9, so we take 9 to stack. Same thing for 8, same thing for 5, for 3, and for 2. Now we can push 1, and we continue. We pop the value 2, and we can directly push it. Same thing for 3, for 5, for 8, and for 9. Now we pop the value 7, it's smaller than 9, so we take 9 to stack, same thing for 8, we take it into stack, now we can push 7, because it's not smaller than 5, and we continue. We pop 8, we can directly push it. We pop 9, and we can also directly push it. Now we have no more elements in stack, it means that we got our stack sorted in descending order in temporary stack. But the final result must be in stack. The temporary stack is here just to help. So let's push all the elements into stack again. We push 9, then 8, then 7, then 5, then 3, then 2, and then 1. And as you can see, we got them in ascending order in stack. The smallest value is at the top, which is exactly what we want. It's because when you push all elements of a stack into another one, they get reversed. Now after we understood how the process works, we need to write the code. In Python, we first define our function. It takes the stack as parameter. Then we create our temporary stack, which is an empty stack at the beginning. After it, we said that we will repeat the process until stack has no elements anymore. So we write, while stack is not empty. Inside this while loop, we said that we pop the element from stack. Let's name it popped element. And here, if you remember, we were each time comparing the value of the popped element with the peak of temporary stack, until the popped element isn't smaller anymore or the temporary stack becomes empty. So we write, while temp stack is not empty and popped element is smaller than the peak of temp stack. And inside this loop, remember that we were moving the temporary stack peak to stack, so pop from temp stack and we push in stack. After finding the right position for where to put our popped element, we push it in temporary stack. And this process gets repeated while stack still has elements as we said. After the while loop, our temp stack is now sorted in descending order, we need now to push its element into the original stack. So while temp stack is not empty, we pop from temp stack and we push into stack. At the end, we have nothing to return because the work happens in place. And as you may know, the time complexity of insertion sort is O of n squared, so our solution runs on O of n squared time complexity. And for the space complexity, here it's O of n because of the temporary stack we used. Now some of you may ask, can we sort a stack in less than O of n squared time complexity? Yes, we can by applying merge sort for example, which has a time complexity of O of n log n. But the problem is, we would need more than one additional stack, which is not allowed in our problem description. We arrived to the end of this video, tell me in comments if you want more videos on data structures, don't forget to check the code in the first link in the description, and see you in the next one.